Thanks for tuning in to another edition of KCBC News. We're so happy you're here today. We're going to have a great show today. A very special guest, Ashley from the Chattahoochee Riverkeeper. Stay tuned. You don't want to miss it. And we're back with our very special guest today. I'm going to give her an opportunity to go ahead and introduce herself.
My name is Ashley Desensi, and I'm the Technical Program Specialist for Chattahoochee Riverkeeper.
That sounds very important, and it is. So let's start out by, tell me a little bit about yourself.
Sure. So I am a Columbus native, so born and raised here. I still am here with my wife and three girls, all teenagers, so that is so much fun right now.
You're in my prayers.
Thank you. And I graduated with both my bachelor's and master's from Columbus State University, so double alum, absolutely love Columbus State. I teach there part-time in the evenings and work full-time for Riverkeeper, and then as an aside, grow up native plants with my wife. And then hike and fish and camp and do all the stuff that I can do to be outside.
So you do it all. I mean, outside of your career, you're busy, busy, busy all around. Okay, for those who don't know, you work for a very important organization, Chattahoochee Riverkeeper.
Yes.
Tell the viewing public, what is the Chattahoochee Riverkeeper, for those who should know but don't?
Sure. So Chattahoochee Riverkeeper is an environmental nonprofit. We've been around, actually, this is our 30th year, so we're very, very excited. We've been around since 1994. We were founded in Atlanta, really to stop the city of Atlanta from continuing to pollute the Chattahoochee River in the early 90s. Well, and they had been doing it for a while. So we are focused on water quality. Our goal is protecting the Chattahoochee River and its tributaries for all the people, the wildlife. We do lots of things like water quality monitoring, water quantity monitoring. So we are very interested in not just how clean the water is, but how the water is used. We do trash cleanups. We do paddles and hikes, and we have floating classrooms and lots of good stuff.
I'm sure the floating classroom, which I'm going to go out and take one of those classes as well, is so important. Water preservation is just so important. The Chattahoochee is a gem that we don't appreciate sometimes as much, but we should, and that's why your job is so important. And I am so proud that you guys are one of our environmental partners, and we get to work together throughout the year, which is really important with what you're doing. What is the formal mission?
Sure, our mission is to protect and conserve the Chattahoochee River and its tributaries, again, for all of those who use it. No matter who you are, you know, no matter your race, your creed, anything like that. And then, of course, the wildlife. So we are a watchdog organization, and our entire role is to advocate on behalf of the river.
That's awesome. And that mission, I'm pretty sure it was what drawn you to, this is the right fit for me. So having that mission and your job, tell them your title again.
So I am the Technical Program Specialist, which basically means I deal with a lot of the programmatic work for Chattahoochee Riverkeeper, especially in the Middle Chattahoochee, which is our region. We have a development side and then we have a program side. And so the work that I do is primarily concerned with construction stormwater, industrial stormwater, industrial wastewater. I run our two neighborhood water watch labs, the new one that we have at Columbus State University and the one in LaGrange in our brand new office location on West Point Lake, which is absolutely gorgeous. And then I deal with the trash traps that are here, work on cleanups and things like that. Of course, come and speak to wonderful organizations like yours, talk to kids groups. And then I run our GIS program, which deals with, mapping and things like that.
Wow, that's a lot. How do you juggle it all? I mean, you are a very busy lady.
My calendar is my best friend, and if it's not on my calendar, it doesn't exist. I don't like monotony, and so this job is actually perfect because there are days when I am able to work from home. There are days when I'm in the Columbus lab, I'm up in West Point Lake. I've got interns all over the place, and so we go out and do creek walks and cleanups and things. So it is a balancing act, but it's one that I really, really enjoy.
I understand. It's quite balancing. And, with people in our field working with the environment, it's kind of challenging. I tell people now with the way the world is pre-pandemic, it's a different. We don't have a pretty job anymore, but it's a fulfilling job. We're doing good work, and that's something we can be proud of.
Yes.
One other question I want to ask you about. I know we talked about what a day looks like for you. Anybody was interested in becoming or getting involved with Chattahoochee Riverkeeper, what do they need to do?
Sure. So you can reach out directly to myself or my coworker, Henry Jacobs, and I can definitely give you all the emails. You can go on our website and look at becoming a member. Membership is wonderful. It helps support all the work that we do. Becoming a member supports the programs, it supports our floating classroom, which again, we have two, one on Lake Lanier and one on West Point Lake. If you would like to dip your toes in the water before becoming a member, you can always volunteer for one of our events, and we have a page on our website that's dedicated to events, and we also post everything on social media as well. So you can follow us on Facebook, Insta. We do have a TikTok as well. So we try to be hip with things. You can follow us on all of our social media. Check out our website for all the information that you're looking for.
Okay, that is awesome. How are you funded?
Sure. So we are a nonprofit, so our funding does come from donations, grants, things like that. We are constantly looking for grants and different type of funding, but membership is a very, very important thing, whether it's just, the $30 membership, or if you decide to do the membership and then donate a little more each month, or we do have some really amazing, bigger donors who are able to give a little bit more. So it is a mix.
I just wanted to give you that plug and a chance tell the public donations are important
yes.
for this type of work and always needed, as well as volunteer. Volunteering is great, but it takes funding to keep it going. We're going to come right back. We're going to take a break. We're coming right back. We're going to talk about a very exciting event that the Chattahoochee Riverkeeper has coming up.
We are out here on Maricopa Creek today doing a creek walk with City of Columbus, Columbus Water Works, and CSU, and we're just looking for things like illicit discharges, potential tap water leaks, sewage leaks, debris.
We see an issue, we either address it on the spot or record it for to go back in the future and work on it then. But we always try to partner with local people to get more people in here, whether Water Works or Riverkeeper.
We're back with Ashley from the Chattahoochee Riverkeeper, and she is about to share with us a very, very important event coming up. So tell us what's coming up.
Okay, so on March 23rd from 9 to 12 is our 14th annual Sweep the Hooch event. So this is a basin-wide event, which means it runs from the headwaters all the way up in Helen, all the way down to the Columbus area. This is a single day cleanup event where we have over 60 sites. We're hoping to have around 1,400 volunteers, and we do a really, really great job of getting trash out of the watershed. And so last year we had over 50 sites, around 1,200 folks that volunteered, and we pulled almost 30 tons of trash out of the watershed in a single day.
That is absolutely awesome. And it's 1,400 that have already registered and signed up.
Pretty close to. We don't have a lot of spots left, but we do have some. So registration does close on the 20th. If you are in the Columbus area, we do have two sites here, and both of those sites have a few spots left. They did when I looked this morning. If they are full, we do have some spots, you know, in the Noonan area, up in West Point, that we could really use some folks if you're willing to take a drive. It's a beautiful, going to be a beautiful weekend. So if everybody registers and we're full, we should have around 1,400 folks volunteering.
That is fantastic. And can you share with us a little bit about, so we will know, what types of organizations can volunteer, or if you want to give a shout out to any of the organizations or individuals that have volunteered?
Sure.
So far.
So we have, you know, other nonprofits that'll come in. I know Atlanta United, they send folks, Home Depot sends folks, Cox sends folks. So we have not only, you know, private businesses, we have other nonprofits that jump in. We are partnering with Dragonfly Trails in Columbus for the Riverwalk spot. Then we just have individuals that come in. The Girl Scouts are an amazing help.
Yes.
They love to get involved. Really anyone and everyone, you know, can join in, and we have some really, really great groups that volunteer every year, but we're always looking for new people.
You just heard it. Anyone can volunteer. Anyone can help. Let me ask you this, Ashley, as we're about to close out. Is there any additional information you want to share?
Sure. Clean water is important to everyone. It doesn't matter who you are. It doesn't matter where you live. If you live in the Columbus area, you are getting your water from the Chattahoochee River, unless you're drinking it from a bottle. But if you're using your tap, if you're bathing, if you're doing laundry, you're getting your water from the river. And I mean, I think that that should speak for itself. However, you know, be kind to the river. Please, you know, come out and volunteer for events like this. Keep Columbus Beautiful does so many cleanup events. Trees Columbus is out there trying to plant trees. We've got all of these amazing environmental groups that are here that people just don't know about. And all of us have this same common goal to protect the environment, and especially this amazing natural resource, which is the Chattahoochee River.
Well said. And you know, what you said is so amazing, because we have these great environmental groups. And the thing about it is, there's no competition. We all work together. I may call Dorothy at Trees Come and say, hey, I need you. Call you guys and say, hey, what are you doing? And we just do so many events together, but we need our people, our community, to really engage more. But not to dismiss, we have a lot of great volunteers, and we're proud of those, but it's all about growing those volunteers so we can do more work.
Yes.
More hands on deck is what it's all about, and getting the message out. And I'm going to close out by asking you one final
Sure.
question. This is a little fun question I like to throw in. If you could be a superhero, who would you be, and why?
Ooh. Well, to be honest with you, growing up, I did watch a lot of Captain Planet. So I think that it's probably pretty fitting. But yeah, I would say some sort of environmental superhero, and come in and, you know, really clean up the environment, just because I grew up in it. I absolutely adore it. I have kids, and I want them to be able to enjoy it the way that I did, and I hope that their children and their children's children can as well, but that can't happen without superheroes like us.
Exactly, and that is really what it's all about. And I want to say this, you have managed to be a hero, because you are a superhero, so you have reached your dream and your goal.
Thank you.
And we're truly proud of the work that you're doing for this community and the surrounding areas and Georgia.
Thank you.
And Alabama, we got to throw those
guys
in.
Yes, Alabama too, they are in our watershed.
They are definitely in our watershed. But thank you so much, Ashley, for coming on.
Thank
always
you.
Great seeing you.
Yeah,
and
absolutely.
I'm sure we'll be talking soon, as
yes,
always.
Ma'am. Thank you.
All right. Thank you. We'll be right back.
Fire! Wind! Water!
Heart!
Go Planet!
By your powers combined, I am Captain Planet!
Captain Planet, he's our hero. Gonna take pollution down to zero. He's our powers magnified, and he's fighting on the planet side. Captain Planet, he's our hero. Gonna take pollution down.
Thank you for watching KCBC News, your leading environmental channel. Be sure to follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Visit our website and CCGTV for our latest episodes and to find more information.
We're back. What an awesome interview and talk with our good friend Ashley from Chattahoochee Riverkeepers. Last month, February, was the month we celebrated Arbor Day, and we had an awesome celebration of trees at the wonderful, beautiful Lake Bottom Park. It was a great event. We had absolutely wonderful partners, Trees Columbus and Columbus Waterworks. So many wonderful partners, Muskogee County Sheriff Department, the Police Department, Chattahoochee River Keepers, Chattahoochee River Conservancy. We had just a host of great vendors that participated. We had our local Boy Scouts. We had our local Girl Scouts. Just so many great people came out and supported this event. We have a little video we're going to show and highlight the event, February 17th, Waricoa Park. It was a great, awesome event. Take a look. Thanks so much for tuning in today for a special show with a great guest, Ashley from the Chattahoochee Riverkeeper. Please make sure you go out and register for Sweep the Hooch, a very important event for a very important river, our Chattahoochee River, our main water source. Be sure to follow us on our social media platforms, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Also, you can always give us a call if you would like to volunteer for any of our upcoming events, 706-225-4008. And I'll close the show today, as I always, asking the big question, what are you doing to keep Columbus beautiful?